Namaskar. Welcome to Satya Skills. In this video, I am going to share some information about Securities Exchange Board of India, very popular as SEBI, the most powerful institution in the capital market in India. During late 80s of the last century, the financial markets were gradually becoming active. To develop them, there was a proposal for a separate board to regulate the activities of capital market. The idea was supported by market experts, and consequently a bill was passed in April 1988 and Securities Exchange Board of India was constituted. It was designed on the lines of Securities and Exchange Commission of USA. Till 1992, SEBI was working on the basis of resolution only. On 21st February 1992, SEBI became a statutory body with powers to regulate capital market under Securities and Exchange Board of India Act 1992. SEBI is managed by statutory board consisting of a chairman and 5 members. Of these, 2 are appointed by the Government of India, 1 member by the RBI, and 2 are by other members. SEBI is an autonomous body with a common seal. Securities Exchange Board of India performs its functions through various departments. Each department is headed by an executive director. They are Primary Market Department, Issue Management and Intermediaries Department, Secondary Market Department, Policy and Operations, Secondary Market Department, Inspection of Stock Exchanges, Institutional Investment Department, very important department, and Investigation Department. Headquarters of SEBI is located at Bombay. It has 3 regional offices to represent 3 regions of India, one at New Delhi for North, Kolkata for East, Chennai to make the responsibility of the South. Advisory committees. SEBI constituted 2 advisory committees to help in execution of its operations. 1 committee takes the responsibility of primary market and 2nd one is for the secondary market. Objectives of SEBI: to protect and guard the interest of investors in security markets of both primary and secondary. About primary market, I will make a video. This is also something very interesting. To promote and develop securities market, to regulate the securities market. SEBI performs the following functions. SEBI regulates the capital market and supervises every activity. SEBI controls and supervises the working of stock exchanges. It has power to inspect the stock exchanges, and then stock brokers, sub brokers, share transfer agents, all institutions, banks, individuals involved in capital issues are provided with the registration facility. That means they have to register with SEBI. SEBI regulates their activities and operations. Foreign institutional investors, credit rating agencies are also regulated by Securities Exchange Board of India. They have to get approval from SEBI and register with it. SEBI regulates and supervises the activities of mutual funds, venture capital funds. Mutual funds you already learned in another video. I will make a video on venture capital soon. Then merchant bankers should register with SEBI to undertake any activity in India. Example, lead managers of public issue, etc. SEBI prohibits unfair trade practices, insider trading, misleading information to investors, etc. in the capital market. About insider trading, I am going to make one interesting video. Then SEBI calls for information, reports, etc. of stock exchanges, mutual funds, self-regulatory, regulating organizations, etc. SEBI grants permission to undertake public issue. About public issue, you are going to learn in in merchant banking. I'll make a video. After abolishing of the Capital Issues Act, SEBI assumed the role of issuing guidelines in this regard. SEBI issues guidelines for various types of debentures, rights issued by listed companies. It frames rules to be followed by various institutions involved in capital markets such as merchant bankers, etc. Powers. The SEBI Act has given extensive powers to SEBI. SEBI can call for periodical returns and can call for any information and explanation from any stock exchange in India. It can make inquiries into the face of the stock exchanges. It grants approval to the bylaws of recognized stock exchanges. SEBI can compel listing and control the working of stock exchanges. It can specify matters relating to capital issue. It can issue directions to those who are associated with the securities market. It regulates every aspect of public issue, including lead managers and approval of prospectus. It regulates depositories, foreign institutional investors, etc. It has power to lay penalty for not obeying to the directions and rules imposed by it. The Securities Exchange Board of India prohibits insider trading and any unfair practices. That's all in this video. Thank you for watching. All the best.